Hi, welcome back. This short video is introduction to Alembic part 2. In the next few minutes, we are going to go over Houdini's powerful surface operators known as SOPS. We will understand how to build a simple transforming animation hierarchy using Houdini's native pack primitive workflow. We will then export the animation as Alembic cache, fire up Maya, Blender, C4D, and set up color attribute for shading and rendering. To follow along, basic understanding of the Houdini interface and its node network is recommended. A sample Houdini file is also attached in the video description for your later reference. So let's begin and dive right inside the geometry node. Working in Houdini involves creating node networks that describe the steps to accomplish a task. Nodes are responsible for all the action inside Houdini. Broadly speaking, a node either creates or modifies incoming data called attributes. In the viewport, you may perceive 3D alphabets, but to the computer, it is plain data. At the very core, bunch of zeros and ones. Fortunately, we don't have to deal with binary as there are several other data types to choose from, and this is something we'll cover in future videos. For now, let's focus on the network editor. We can think of Houdini's node graph as a stream of data or attributes flowing from top to down. Order of execution flow is top to bottom, left to right. Computing result of the node network is termed as cooking. On the top left, we have letters lined up and feeding into the loop indicated by the brown shaded area. Inside the loop, each alphabet is being acted upon by three nodes. First in chain is transform node, which is modifying incoming geometry's position data by sending it to the origin. Second is color swap, responsible for creating color data on the incoming geometry. Here we are reading the data from the template points using a point hscript function. We can visualize the dependency links by going to the view and turning on the show for selected node. Make sure ColorSwap's class is set to vertex when exporting model for Maya. Leave it to the point for software such as Blender or C4D. Third in chain is pack node. It converts incoming geometry data to Houdini's native in-memory packed primitive. Packing means that the embedded geometry becomes a one uneditable primitive with a single transform. At the end of the loop, we get 26 different packed geometries sitting at the origin. Let's validate it by turning on single pass on the block node. Moving down the chain is a copy to points node. It copies incoming geometry from the first input onto the points of the second input based on an index. On the second input, we got template points coming in with data attributes for color, CD, and animated normals N. Copy to point is using normal attribute for orienting the copies. As a result, we have our final layout of 26 alphabets as 26 individual packed primitives. All that is left now is to define the hierarchy. To do so, we will tag each alphabet with a unique string value using attribute wrangle node. This little piece of X expression is creating a unique string attributes per packed primitive called path. At the end of the chain, we have Alembic Rob using path attribute to build a hierarchy. Make sure pack transform is set to merge with parent transforms. Let's go ahead and write this out. Here we are in Maya. Let's import the Alembic cache. The outliner shows the hierarchy, two levels of transform, and actual alphabet mesh at the shape node level. It's fully editable. We can break the connections and modify. Now comes the Arnold shading part. Let's drop AI standard surface shader on the geometry. For Arnold to pick vertex color, we need to turn on export vertex color property on the shape node. This can be done at once with attribute spreadsheet editor found in Windows General Editor's attribute spreadsheet. To edit, go to Arnold tab and filter by typing color, select the entire column and hit 1 on the keypad. All that is left now for Arnold shader is to read the value. So let's open up Hypershade, graph the AI standard surface shader assigned on the geometry, pipe in our AI user data color node to the base color and make sure to give the incoming attribute name as CD. That's what color defaults to in Houdini. let's drop in a light and hit render. Blender is very straightforward. Let's import the cache. Assign the material and drive the base color by input vertex color, name it CD. Make sure the material preview is on, select all the alphabets, go to the object, make link, select material, that's all. A quick look inside C4D. While importing Alembic, make sure you turn on the color maps and other attributes. In the project manager, we can turn on Alembic tag to visualize color attribute. Let's create a new PBR material. To drive base color with vertex map, in the texture slot, choose effects, vertex map. Drag and drop the Alembic tag CD into the field. Select all the letters, assign the material, and that's pretty much it. It brings us to the end of part 2. Hope you've learned something new and enjoyed as much as I did while making it. Do provide your valuable suggestions and feedback in the comment section. Thanks for watching. Until next time.